Hi, welcome to my channel. Today, we've got a story from our / surviving infidelity where op's wife of 17 years has been emotionally cheating on op and does not know what and who she wants. Before we start, if you have any personal stories of how you got out of a toxic relationship with your cheating wife or girlfriend that you want to share, feel free to email them to me. Let's get started. Original story. Our story. We started dating in fall 1997 or spring of 1998. Never been able to pinpoint down when the two of us became an official we. Definitely kissed her in 97, but we were pretty loose for a while. We'd go out on dates with each other, then other people, then back together and began spending more and more time with each other, and by the summer there was definitely an us. She got an apartment across the parking lot at the complex I was living in the fall of 98, and because one of the ass clowns I was friends with at the time wouldn't move out, I moved in with her that fall, clothes and bed at my apartment, slept every night in hers. We were happy. And by the fall of 2001, I asked her to marry me, and we're married in 2002. Spent the first several years together having fun, and had our first child in 07, and his brother in 11. Been in a happy, committed relationship for 21 years, coming in on 17 married. We are realists that marriage is never perfect, it has its highs and its lows. We are both musicians and have always equated marriage to a good piece of music, has its moments that are forte, high, raucous, and its moments that are pianissimo, lows, wrought with emotion? We have always shared this sentiment with budding couples of newlyweds. Just roll with it and embrace it for what it is. If you don't have the lows / fights, you aren't living an authentic relationship. Lol, we had it all figured out, right? We have had some recent stress. After living our entire lives in one region, we decided to take a jump and move to another part of the country. This was followed by a layoff within the first 18 months, leading to another move, even further from home. We have now settled into our new home, and find that the company we moved here for no longer has a home for us in it, leading to another job change. This has been hard on my spouse. Where it all went wrong. I have been suspicious of something going on for a while now and had begun losing sleep on the issue. It began with an anecdotal story in July of last year about a coworker on a work trip in Vegas that had been sharing some very intimate company insider information with my spouse. She indicated that he should not have been telling, but was drunk and perhaps a bit lippy. It honestly sounded like pillow talk. Based on the nature of the relationship, I pointed it out to her and was a bit prickly when she mentioned him again, but passed it off on a friendly relationship and that there was nothing to worry about. Then as fall rolled around, there were more and more tells of something off. A change in grooming habits, some new lingerie, and some other little pieces. The biggest was one night while we were having sex, she began to cry. I couldn't figure out what exactly was happening. She mentioned that she was going through some stuff and might even act a little strange for a period, and not to take it to heart, just got to give her some space. Well, all of this added up in my mind, and I asked her several times if something was going on and was she cheating on me. The night of Christmas Eve to Christmas, I decided I needed resolution and would take matters into my own hands by looking at her texts on her phone to find evidence. I did not plan for it that morning. Yes, Christmas morning while breakfast was being cooked in the glow of torn wrapping paper tossed around the Christmas tree, but I ended up with her phone, helping to transfer son's old pics to a new phone, and did a quick review. Found the text I hoped would not be there and only words remember seeing were, I cannot take you being all over me 1 minute and ignore me another. I was fucking devastated instantly. Fucking destroyed. I couldn't breathe, I couldn't stand, I couldn't talk. My son was in the room, said something, you okay dad? I stumbled into the kitchen and told her I found a message on her phone. To her credit, we walked outside and talked through it. She claims to have given me the blow by blow and full disclosure. Three total events. First event, in his apartment in another state where he has relocated and she was visiting for work while her company moves, she went over to cook hot dogs for a restaurant concept. He came up behind her and she leaned into it and kissed him back. They went into his bedroom and made out. She claims they stopped before either got naked and there was no sex. Second event, 2 days later in the office in the other state. Third event, the last time was in the local office, on December 14th, 11 days before I found out about them. Later that week, she let me read the entire text chain back and forth between them. She and I both know this is only part of the story. They were able to talk in person, email, and work IM. I have not seen any of these other communications. From what I read, it appeared that the notion that they had not had sex was confirmed. She told me that they were done, the intimate relationship was done, but through work and the relationship they needed to have for the business, they would still be in contact. Initially, she indicated that they would work through intermediaries, however, that clearly devolved and they were rather quickly back to email and IM. I told her that I needed to know that they were finished. She needed to take decisive action to end the relationship so I could sleep at night and find a path forward. Needless to say, and to nobody's surprise, I was crushed. I was hopeless and in despair. I was not angry with her, but kept asking the question why. Why did this happen? I have done nothing but love her and be patient, she even admits she is not the easiest to live with. We had fun together and knew when toggling each other's space, it was a success where others have failed. We returned from our trip to the other coast to visit family for the holidays and after a couple of weeks set up couples therapy. This was surprisingly a chore for her. I picked out a list of therapists and told her who I liked best. She told me she wanted a woman and took her time picking out one. We went to our first session, and it appeared that we were in locked steps to find a way forward. However, we stepped on a bit of a landmine. While our therapist was discussing the process, she said the phrase, "This is what we will do, if this is what you want." For some reason that triggered my wife to question what she wanted. She needed clarity on why she chose to act on her urges and attraction to another man, despite her marital relationship with me. She asked for a pause on the couple's therapy, pointing out that each of us needed to work on ourselves first. She mainly needed to answer the question why. This was crushing to me. How could she not know what she wants? Couple this with the knowledge that despite my repeated and clear requests to end the relationship with him, even if no longer physical and was above the board, she was still carrying a friendly/fraternal relationship with him. Then the further blows come in that have crippled me. Thursday 1/17, I am taking my kids to basketball practice and ask her to join me, but she says she is going to work late instead. I drive by the office seeking a quick hug and kiss. I am needy in this space, and her office is dark, she's not there. I confront her on the issue and she claims that she had just run out of a forgotten waxing appointment. Friday 1/18, I find the image of a text from him, "Hide in the kitchen if I promise not to kiss you," her response count to 10. I confront her and tell her to end it or I am moving out the next day. When we meet up later, she says I took care of it. I find out just days later she did nothing. Monday 1/21, she texts him and a group of friends at work. I don't know the details of the text, only that she texted him. Wednesday 1/23, she returned early from a business trip. This is unheard of from her. Been with her a long time. I might remember a handful of times when she came home early from work, let alone a business trip. Thursday 1/24, she goes to happy hour with work friends to celebrate a peer that was leaving. She says in advance he might be there, she later admits that he was, but she ignored him and they did not interact. Yeah, okay. Sarcasm. That night she turned off the Find My iPhone app on her phone, despite location services being turned off, I never could tell where she was. I later find a text to two of the friends going, urging them not to flake out, that she, my wife, had planned this happy hour only because he was there and that they needed to come too. Not this bullshit story that he might stop by, she planned the fucking event expressly for him to come. These events have killed me inside. Not only did she beat me down with the initial infidelity, but she continued to dig the knife into my heart with repeated trauma. I've cried more than I ever thought humanly possible, and even shared with her brief, oh so fleeting moments, of hurting myself. I have talked to my therapist about this notion, I am going to be okay, yet she still took this selfish, inconsiderate action. I knew what was happening, yet I did nothing like a fucking pussy. I told myself I loved her too much and needed her in my life, that I must find a way to trust and give space while she seeks out clarity with her therapist. This crucial insight is paramount to me. I want to find our way forward, but she has to be 100% in it, not just there because of an obligation/comfort with the kids, or I. I vowed to move out this weekend, even reached out to a friend to find a place to stay. Then Friday, she let me know that she had taken action to end the relationship. She spoke to him in person in the office on Friday and told him they could no longer have contact with each other. She told him that she was making a choice and that they were no more. She even offered me evidence in a text from him saying farewell and that they had each blocked the other's number for texting. I should be elated, I should be happy that there is an indication of hope for a shared future together, yet I am skeptical. She is still the captain of her domain. What stops her from acting out with him, or someone else, again? Can I live with myself that I allow her to deceive and disrespect me? How can I know that she is not taking my love for granted? It's a long path forward, I just hope we make it. Before we take a look at some replies by other Redditors, take a moment to like the video to show your support to the channel. Don't forget to leave your own opinion on the story in the comments down below. Now let's look at some comments. You/Fatboy Slim wrote, "Regardless of what you decide, your trust in her is broken. How to move forward is a question only you can answer. This said, please stop doing the pick me dance. It will always work against you. Your attitude from the beginning should have been you want out. Get out in a cool-headed brain frame. Crying, begging, calling her names, getting into arguments, doing the pick-me dance will only play against you. The way you get a wife back is by simply showing her you have options. AKA, more than one woman in line to have something with you. So, get a new hairstyle, groom yourself differently, and go out to happy hours with, pay attention to this terminology, just a friend from work, gym, or whatever. None of what you do should lead to an argument, so get a gym membership, start your yoga, yes yoga, spinning classes and get to meet new people. You need to have options, and these changes in appearance, style, etc. are for you. Not her. These changes are meant to get you back. You/Skyscan1 wrote. Where are the consequences of her having an ongoing affair and continuing to destroy your heart and your trust? None. You have played the pick-me dance over and over. You wanted her to pick you over her fantasy affair partner. She never had to face the shame of having an affair. She didn't have to change jobs. She didn't have to open all her communications and social media and GPS to you to rebuild trust. What has she had to do? She lied each time she said they were finished. But you should believe her now. Expose her to all of her family and friends. Contact her human resources at work and inform them of the affair. Expose her to everyone. Affairs love to remain hidden. Make her change jobs or divorce. You are the better pick here. You didn't cheat and lie and deceive for months. She is the broken one. She is the one that is sullied. Who wants to commit to a spouse that will behave as she has? Go see a divorce lawyer. Let her see that her actions have consequences. I think then her affair fog will begin to lift and she will begin to see how awful she has behaved. Look for the remorse when her family and friends know that she is a cheater. Look for the remorse when she has to find another job. If the affair partner has a wife or girlfriend, make certain they know about the affair. Look for her to grieve the relationship. Don't ask her to pick you anymore. Make her ask you to please not throw her away for being a bad spouse. You/1 badshot wrote. Loving her did not keep her faithful. Being patient with her did not keep her faithful. Going to therapy to not keep her faithful. Why do you keep falling for this? She didn't end it before and she didn't end it now. She is telling you exactly what you want to hear because you are her second place, her second best, her fallback position. Stop letting her have her cake and eat it too. There have to be consequences for her betraying you, betraying your marriage, and betraying your family. Read and implement the 180. Your wife needs to know how badly she has hurt you and your family with her selfishness. Make her prove she loves you and wants to be with only you. You/the Mockingbird wrote. She needs to quit her freaking job and give you her phone password for easy access. She spun this lie about ending things multiple times, but in your heart you know she never did stop seeing/sleeping with him. Maybe this time is different, but I have to ask, is it honestly worth the hurt? Maybe consider separating yourself for a few days, even after her ending things with this guy. Time apart may give you some clarity and reinforce whatever decision you plan to do. I recommend having her leave. Not sure why you had to sink so low to leave yourself, she's the cheater, who broke your trust time and time again. Aside from that, if you choose to reconcile, don't give her any more chances. You've given her enough, the clear disrespect on her part is disgusting. I don't know if I'd personally be capable of continuing to love someone like that. Are you sure you are still in love with her? And not some past distant memory of what she was? Hate to say it, but she's not that person anymore, and she'll never be. You can lie and convince yourself that she's the same loving wife, but the cheating and lies will never go away. Get some space to figure things out. Her actions are disgusting and I can't even fathom to think the damage she's caused to your psyche. I don't think reconciling is worth the trouble. You are the only one who's been willing to put in the effort. What has she done? She's lied multiple times, continued her affair to an extent and has only now decided to end things. That doesn't prove shit. It's probably another lie. Take a step back and separate yourself to gain some clarity. Let her do the work regarding your reconciliation to see if she's truly trying to save your marriage. I still recommend kicking her out, it'll reinforce what she's losing, and give you time to process everything. Her behavior surrounding the previous incidents can't happen again. If you're a cheater, you shouldn't be going to parties that the AP might be at, hell, you shouldn't go at all. Especially so soon after D-Day. She's been selfishly continuing her affair until now. Her behavior around you was also similar before you realized she never stopped. The question you asked about whether you'd be able to live with yourself if you stayed is interesting, and I recommend thinking about it during your separation. Don't give her the benefit of the doubt, she's a liar without remorse, two things that shouldn't be associated with someone attempting reconciliation. Have her quit her job, for a peace of mind, aside from that, please think things through. You/the Roomaway wrote, The best scenario for reconciliation is when the cheater is begging for forgiveness and willing to do anything to atone. And when the betrayed spouse proceeds with caution, emotionally detach a little and is willing to lose the marriage if the disrespect continues. She is disrespecting the shit out of you. You can go with making demands, like quitting the job, monitoring her phone and computer. Eventually this is exhausting and humiliating, and insisting on no contact, but these should be her ideas, not yours. She's either done with the marriage or is confident that you're too afraid to leave her. Either way, she's putting her desires far ahead of your health. Very selfish and disrespectful. You/Reefman1 wrote. This will continue until you decide to stop it. You are being lied to, manipulated, disrespected, and made to look like a fool. You say that she has stopped it several times. That's a lie. She says that they never fucked, that's a lie. She has been trickle-truthing you and you have been believing her. Stop that. It is painful to read this because of how badly you have been jerked around. You have to end the bullshit. Tell her to call AP in front of you and tell him it's over. She then deletes and blocks his number, and shows you. She has to give you complete access to her phone, activate the tracking app, learn how to use it. She gives you complete access to email, computer, all social media, all apps, all messaging apps. Search her phone for hidden apps and hidden folders. Get and run software on her phone that recovers deleted items and finds hidden material. Tell her that it is no contact with AP ever again. And tell her that there will be no work with him and absolutely no travel. Tell AP's wife now, she deserves to know. Tell your family, her family, and your friends what is happening. Tell her work, the HR department, or executives about the affair between co-workers. Who knew about the affair and didn't tell you? Find out and cut those people out of your life. When people ask what happened, tell them completely and truthfully. This is not your fault, it's all on her. It is up to her to reconcile with you and fix her problems. If she doesn't do all of these things, kick her out. You should not move out, she is the problem, not you. You need to take care of yourself and your children. Do not back down, this has gone on this long because you kept believing her and didn't hold her to her word. You cannot and must not negotiate with her, she will just lie some more. Give her the ultimatum to comply with these demands or get the fuck out. Get tested for STDs and make her get tested too. You should lawyer up, get your options, make the point that you are serious, file and serve her, give her until it's final to convince you to stop it. Get up and get moving, you have a lot to do. What do you think about all of this? Do you think Op should just cut his losses and divorce? Or, do you think there's hope for reconciliation? Let us know in the comments down below. If you like the video, subscribe to the channel to see more videos like this. Hit the notification bell to make sure you never miss an upload.